Latvia this week, and unfortunately I'll not be able to create the blog. So those guys in the tents outside Roland, Levinsky, everybody asking what they're trying to accomplish, what their thoughts, what they're doing. We went there, impromptu interview. It was quite hard because the lady with the crazy dog started to interrupt us and almost eat it my friend Ben, who is filming now. So this is what we have now for you. You know, the people in the background, and everybody sort of interested what they think, what they wanted, what they try to say. Like, becoming 99% of what is says on every single transparent, yeah? So this is what I'll try to basically do, is first of all try to communicate. I'll explain this. I'm from Plymouth University, and then ask them to explain what they try to accomplish. Thank you, let's go. So my name is Dmitrij, and basically we are part of Economic Society, and you're here for a while already.
Yeah, we've been here since Saturday.
First of all, isn't it cold?
Yeah, pretty. Right, we've got a nice fire going.
Okay, so first question, because I recently like drive through and realize that you're here.
Yeah.
Wonderful. 99%, what sort of 99% are we talking about? What's it all about?
The 99% is the 99% of the population that aren't up in their great big white towers profiting on the rest of, on everything going around while the rest of us are suffering. Most of it is like big corporations like Vodafone.
Yeah.
Vodafone last year got let off £6 billion in tax. Now they're a multi-million corporation.
Richard
Branson number one. What?
He's number one.
Yeah.
A lot of his tax he puts it offshore, so he doesn't have to pay tax.
And right.
He owns Virgin Media.
So he earns a lot of things.
Yeah. He earns a lot of money.
Right.
And because he puts it offshore.
Put it offshore.
So he doesn't have to pay tax.
Right. Okay.
Which is wrong.
Can I ask you a question? Are you employed?
No.
Right, okay, just general question.
I'm not camping here, I'm just a passerby.
All right, okay, so but you understand that's Richard Branson. It's just like, it's not like I'm not supporting, if you want, in the middle, in between. But Richard Branson, at the same time, he's investing in things like internet, galaxy, traveling, and so sort of things which are moving the process.
Yeah, but he's not paying what he should be paying in taxes. You'll find that the richer the person is, the less they pay in the
taxes. Okay, explain in this way how we suffer
from this. We're suffering in everything. The cuts are going on. I mean, the pensions are being changed, so less people are in their 60s are getting their pensions. You've got to work longer until you're 65 now. The police are being cut, the armed forces are being cut. The whole public sector as a whole is being cut down to the brink. Where, right. Because there's not enough money in the system. But there is money go around. People aren't making enough money to pay their white taxes. Both of them last year got let off £6 billion in tax. Now, if I tried to do that, yeah, I'd be in prison for not paying my taxes.
Right.
So why should these multi-million corporations get let off that sort of money when the rest of us, the elderly that have their heating stuff, their heating package as a whole, the money they get for their heating through the winter, has been cut by half to put more money into the system. Now, why should that happen when multi-million corporations are being let off that kind of money for taxes?
Right, okay, one question. If people here, majority of them, employed?
Majority are employed. I'm employed myself.
Yep.
Majority are employed. Some are unemployed that are looking for work, finding it more difficult to find work because there's not enough money going around the system into these small companies like
out there.
that let them be employed. The guys here aren't the people that sat around their houses all day just claiming off the system and claiming dough. They are out looking for work, they're here supporting us and they're looking for work. We've got students here that go to the uni across the road. They're camped out here supporting us and doing their uni course at the same time. I mean, they've been in their tents doing their course work.
Yeah.
I want to get across that we're not just a bunch of lazy layabouts. We're here for a reason. I work for the day. I mean, I've taken the day off. The shuttle support and do the information there. But yeah, I work. I come to shuttle support. I come to the general assemblies. It's not just a bunch of places.
No, but this is the whole point. There's another kind of sample of population who actually see it as actually people who sit on their asses, not working. Because basically, if you ask every second person from Plymouth University, everybody see really bright future and perspectives.
Yeah.
Really, because everybody basically don't bother taking that debt or whatever, using it in terms of learning.
and just going forward with the job and doing stuff.
Yeah, but there's another problem with the fact that a lot of people coming out of university with these brilliant degrees and these brilliant minds not being able to be employed.
Maybe mine's not so brilliant in this class.
You don't know until you get out the other end.
And he came out, he had all he could come to the right qualifications, he came out straight age, right? And he couldn't get a job in his suit. He's working in the shop. And he's got a degree.
But you see, don't you think the problem lies in the government system? That government allows people to go to university using debt? Because if it were you paying the cash, you would more likely not going to university but going straight into employment.
Oh, let's go straight into work.
Yeah, this is the point. That's why, maybe it's not a problem of corporate governments, it's a problem of government as such. But that's why I just think you're addressing the question wrong, completely.
I
might not be explaining myself properly.
No, I'm just trying to get the official.
Equality distribution. I'm not against it. I'm against the majority of the capitalist system, where the rich are getting richer and the poor are getting poorer.
Bankers make a loss and still get a bonus. Now, where you tell me where that's right? This country and the euro are in a state. You watch the news, look at what Greece is in. They're in a right state. The euro is in turmoil, right? Because the bankers making cocky little stupid mistakes and still giving themselves backhanders, basically, right? Because it's all down to greed. Or a lot of people in are too interested in that and not helping out other people. The poor kids in the suit with a John Lewis shopping list. I mean, what that politician, right, claiming porno, right, expecting the state to pay the taxpayer to pay for her husband to watch porn.
Right.
And doing the house flipping. They're all at it, mate. They've all got the noses in the trough.
As a final point, because it's our blog, it's university society, do you want to deliver some message or information to students of our courses?
Our course is not just for us, it's for everyone. Students, come along, show your support, because you guys are being affected by this as well. Your student fees are going up and up and up, and yet £1 million corporations aren't helping you guys out in any way. So come down, show your support, we're here for everyone.
Thank you very much, thank you.